stepping through the city like, what's up, black?
What's up, black?
Black 40 on my side, they know what's up, black.
They know what's up,
any
black
problem, we swallow and spit, then we get off.
Nigga,
big
get
homies
off.
Talk niggas talking for buses and just get off.
Niggas,
got
get
a gun,
off.
No registration, yeah. Gotta live up to your reputation.
Yeah.
It might take you a couple demonstrations.
Fuck.
Play a cold game of elimination.
Yeah.
It's like I'm staring into my own eyes on a soldier I'm eliminating. I'm deep sleep, stuck in this dream, still I feel awakened. Lost
awake
on this mission for God, when times I feel I'm Satan.
Feel
and get
Satan.
My bitch spoiled, she act like she just hit all. Got
get
Louis on her person bag, but fuck this shit, I
fuck
get all.
It.
My
get
nose
up
in this money bag, bitch bad and bougie. If a flag on my face, my bitch grabbing a Uzi. And this shit premeditated, the plan of a genius.
My
like
genius.
God with the rib could be nothing without the penis. Genius,
genius.
Once again, thank you, Young Word, for tuning in to another season of ITLTTV podcast. We have none other than the living legend, my favorite rapper's favorite rapper, your favorite rapper's favorite rapper, probably your favorite rapper, the OG in the game, Mr. Mob Father, Mr. Ball Head Nut, Sebo himself. Rounds of applause, everybody. We're here on 420 at this crazy establishment he got popping. We're celebrating 30-year anniversary of the gas chamber.
Yes, yes.
Sebo, take us back 30 years to the making of the gas chamber.
Gas chamber. One-bedroom apartment. Milk crate, four-track, mattress on the floor.
The real struggle.
Yeah, it started like that, you know what I mean? You know, it started all in an oak tree with a lawnmower. You know what I'm saying? So, and we here.
So it started from the struggle. Mm-hmm. We're here at legendary status.
You know what I mean?
Who was your favorite artist? What hip hop artist was young Sebo listening to?
Back then it was like, you know, Blowfly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Name, Blowfly.
Shout out to Blowfly.
Yeah, shout out to Blowfly. My mama had his record.
My name is Blowfly, and I want to welcome you to the fresh show of the evening.
Heard this motherfucker cussing out Superman and calling Superman a punk and all that. I said, God, this must be a bad motherfucker.
Okay.
You feel me?
And what was that, Blowfly?
Blowfly.
Blowfly.
Yeah.
So I'm new to that.
Oh my
Shout out to Blowfly.
Yeah, Google Blowfly.
Google Blowfly. Google this guy. So
that's
when we were doing our research and we were Googling Mr. Sebo, Sacramento's living legend, we found at least 31 albums.
Yeah.
Streaming back from 1993. Look at the list, guys.
Right.
You got now.
Sticking and moving, you know.
Sticking and
always
moving.
Always working. Always knowing that, you know, any day can be your last day. You know
right.
what I mean? So I was like a workaholic. And then I was dealing with, you know, the prison parole shit I was going through. So I had to stay in the studio and work.
So when did your juvenile stint end?
Right before I made Gas Chamber, I paroled from CYA and wound up going on the run. And my
you paroled and went on the run?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, went on the run and wound up making the Gas Chamber.
Okay. On the run?
Yeah.
Okay.
And creating AWOL Records.
Right. I was going to ask you about that. So you created AWOL Records?
No, me and my homie.
Okay.
My homie had the, money. I had the lyrics.
Shout out to the creators of AWOL Records.
Yeah, yeah.
And so from there we have, in 93, you dropped the Gas Chamber. 95, you dropped Tales from the Crypt with AWOL. One Life to Live in 97 with AWOL.
Mm.
So that was like AWOL and On the Run music.
On the Run.
On the Run music. Now, we dropped Till My Casket Drop and the final chapter, 1999, with AWOL.
Casket Drop was 98.
Right.
97. I want to say, yeah, 98.
But One Life to Live, your discography says One Life to Live
they might
was
be
in
off
97.
They might be off a year. I think that's 96.
See.
I think that's 96. You know,
okay.
I could be wrong, though. You know what I mean? But, hey, it's been a long journey.
It's been a long journey. So, but you did drop the final chapter in 99.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was with AWOL, too.
Yeah, yeah.
Then you went with Warlock Records.
Right.
2000, Enemy of the State.
Enemy of the State, Warlock.
So.
But that was a recap. See, Warlock was after Till My Casket Drop. So to my casting drop was the last one, not whatever one.
The final chapter.
Final chapter. Yeah, that was before to my casting drop.
Okay. So we're gonna have to get our information together.
It's all good.
Internet.
Yeah, so I had to get to my casket drop. It was Enemy of the State.
Okay.
You feel me? That was a deal with Warlock, new deal on the East Coast with a new label and my own label, you know what I mean, deal. So it's my first making a big move on my own, you know what I'm saying?
So what was the environment like at Warlock Records now that you're a signed artist?
Well, they were on the East Coast, and we was on the West Coast.
Okay.
We pretty much was turning in our music, and they was cutting the check.
Okay.
You know, we didn't have to go out there, you know what I'm saying, and sweat them about no paper or nothing like that. Even though we knew where their office was and shit, you know what I'm saying, but we turned in the music, they sent the check. It was cool.
So, did you keep, like, in your contract, the ability to work with other companies, drop music with other labels?
No, at that time we had a distribution deal through them. And even though I probably could have swindled through somewhere else, and I don't think that was in my contract that I couldn't, but you know, why? I was right. They was feeding me, you know what I mean? Ain't no sense to burn them when they're feeding me.
So 2001, the next year from, you know, my research, mm-hmm. It says you did the Block Movement with Brother Lynch with Warlock Records and J-Core Entertainment.
Yeah, J-Core, that was a branch off from Priority. You know what I'm saying, Brian and Bob Grassi. They started a company from Priority, and then they needed a new artist. Mm-hmm. They needed something over there, so me and Brother Lynch came together for the record.
So, what artist was from Priority? Because I remember Priority.
Ice Cube.
Right. Straight facts. Shout out to Priority Records.
Oh yeah.
And from there, you dropped some more with Warlock Records, Life as a Rider, O2, Desert Eagle, O2, Bulletproof,
yeah.
O3, sheesh. Oh wait, Bulletproof was with California Entertainment. Tell us about that.
Bulletproof was an album that probably was just sitting in the files that they put together and branched off with another company to help promote it or whatever.
So you pioneered a lot of companies.
Sure.
A lot of business. Sure. A lot of people don't know that you were very pivotal in pioneering the Fuck the Police movement.
Well, when you come from the streets, you know, the police don't help you. Never have. Well, you come from where I'm from, you feel me? You know, life of crime and shit, trying to be like somebody else, you know, led by the wrong type of people, you could say, you know, so. It is what it is. They ain't done nothing wrong.
It is what it is. They ain't doing nothing wrong. We just living, striving, and surviving.
Trying to survive. That's it. That's
right.
It.
You heard it from the legend. Strive to survive. So you've been open in previous interviews about spending a large part of your youth in the juvenile system, the juvenile penal system. What's the difference? What did you find was the difference from being in juvie prison to adult prison? Were you in adult prison?
Yeah. Juvenile prison, more active, you know, more hothead, little niggas and shit, trying to prove a point, more fights, more everything. Prison, more serious, you know what I'm saying, and a bunch of bickering shit. It's either going down or, you know what I mean, it's not. Yeah.
So let's get back to a funner note, to the music.
Yeah.
To the music. Okay. 2003. We're introduced to West Coast Mafia Records, is that correct? With SIBO and West Coast Mafia Gang.
That could be right.
Shout out to the mob.
But West Coast Mafia Records was put out Enemy of the State.
Okay.
You feel me? Yeah.
And so also you did in 2003 was a very, very busy year for you. We got Desert Eagle, Bulletproof, SIBO, West Coast Mafia Gang, Hit and Run.
Yeah.
Then The Mob Father in 2003.
Yeah, we was going in every 2 months, every 3 months.
Game. A decade at this point, right? From 93 to 03.
Yeah.
So what was the feeling going in to make this album, The Mob Father?
Had my own label, had my own shit going, own deal.
Bossed up.
Had my own crew, I had them, you know. I was just making moves for other people, trying to put other people in better positions, for the artists and shit. You know, and we came with the mob father.
Okay.
You know?
Yes, he was big bossed up. Dropped it on West Coast Mafia Records.
Yeah.
Decades in, over 10, 12 albums out. Over that, guys. So we get into 2004 with the Hindu Mafia.
Step foot in Arizona, ran into my guys, Hindu Mafia.
Shout out to the Mafia.
You feel me? Me and one of the younger brothers, which is my age, you know what I'm saying? I guess, you know, back then, and we got tight. And he wanted to do music. And I was in a position to, you know, bring him right in, and that's what I did. Yep, Hindu Mafia. Shout out to the Hindu Mafia.
Out to the Hindu Mafia.
Yes, sir.
So didn't Bombay come from the Hindu Mafia?
Yeah.
Shout out to Bay, the little bro.
Shout out to Bombay.
Yeah. Let's see here. Thug Lords with Yuck Mouth. So that was back in 04, 05.
Y'all know what I mean? It's your boy Yuck Mouth kicking in on ITLTTV with Ladyboss, CerSire. You dig? Yada da!
Kinda broke the scene, y'all, so all I got.
Do you think the West Coast artists are pretty tight?
Yeah, we is.
Tight knit.
We is. It's levels of tightness.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
But it's definitely some core industry. The more tight you is, what?
The more lower you go down, the more tight they get. You know what I'm saying? But it's a good thing over there. Everybody's, you know, working. Everybody working.
Okay. Now we're just gonna go back a little bit. 1999, you dropped "See Me" with Juvenile. Now he's a South. He's considered Southwest.
Juvenile's from the South.
The South. Okay.
Yeah.
Juvie. Shout out to New Orleans.
Shout out to Juvie. Yeah, no, Juvie was, I was in Atlanta. He was in Atlanta. He was working. You know, it's just like, man, jump on the track. You know what I'm saying? And wind up get down with him.
Yeah, so much music, I think, that didn't get the ample. I mean, his music definitely gets heard and is felt by the fans, but a lot of mainstream play. Do you feel like you didn't get as much mainstream play as you should have?
I never was mainstream, though. To be mainstream, you got to be signed to a big label and be pushed by radio and all these different little, you know, things.
But all the mainstream artists loved you, though.
That's cool, because that's what they grew up on.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
The real
show. I was underground, so even though I got around, you know? I got around. But, you know, no tours, no big tours or none of that. Just straight independent.
And looking back 30 years in the game, do you believe independent is the route for the new generation to go?
For sure. There's no reason to sign
the
alliance.
Did you hear that? No reason to sign that.
Nah. You can do it all on your own, with your own, you know, the avenues they have now. Mm-hmm. It's easy to sign up for DistroKid or whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Make sure you learn your business. Learn the business of music, your publishing, your cataloging, percentages, copywriting, everything you need to know. Because it's a business, guys.
Yeah.
And in this business, he Juvenile, Little Flip, then we get to E40.
Yep, those are all of my businesses.
What about 40? How many songs have you done with E40?
Oh, I don't know. 5 or 6, I don't know.
Okay. That was dope. I was looking like, oh, I didn't know. So shout out to E40, shout out to the Bay.
Shout out to the Bay, man.
Now we're going to take you back and then take you forward to the project that I think I met you working on. Your favorite song on Gas Chamber.
On Gas
Chamber? Guys, make sure to hit those links. Check out some of the classics. Now your Animal album. That was what, 2019?
Animal.
20.
Yeah.
Okay. 2018. Do you have a favorite song on your Animal album?
Animal. minimum album. What song was I playing? Damn.
Too many albums, too many songs.
Can't even remember the motherfucking titles.
Nah, I remember you shot a video
all
to one of
pussy.
Them.
That's
that the it, at the compound.
Yeah, that's how it is.
So how'd you get introduced to the compound?
Somebody took me over there, said it was a studio over there. Took me to Jack's.
Mm-hmm. You ended up collabing with so many other artists over there.
Yeah, but you know, I went over there as me, you feel
yeah,
me?
Absolutely.
So, you know, everybody wanted to meet me and shit.
He's the legend. Everybody wants to meet him.
But, yeah, I worked with everybody. I was like that, you know what I mean? I'm gonna fuck with you if I see you solid.
Absolutely. Let's jump to the, am I pronouncing it right, Orca?
Orca.
Where was SIBO at in that album, in life? Orca. Have it as 2012.
Orca was on parole, fresh out. I was on bond, federal bond. So niggas that say you can't bond out on the feds, you don't know what you're talking about. Bonded out. And I was going to court when I made that record right there. So I guess that shit was so long. I
right.
Not, on that
so you got more music
I got
that he done forgot that. Than niggas
yeah,
got in their catalog.
On 40 on that record too.
Shout out to E-40. 40 Wada Wada. Wada.
He blessed me, did the shit for me on there.
Okay. So, now to my favorite feature, like of all the hundreds of features that you've done, the feature that introduced me to SIBO was the legendary Trading War Stories with Tupac. That's when me, an Ohio girl, shout out to Columbus, Ohio, that's when the music made it to me. But the city was already saturated because I was hearing songs, but you know, you don't know until you hear it again, like, oh yeah, I know that.
Right.
But in Trading War Stories, that was what? What year was that?
96.
96, right. She's 16, bopping.
95.
Rapping.
Around
so, how was that session?
Out of control.
Out of control. I'm like, who this nigga think he is trying to out rap Pac? Because y'all know I'm one of Tupac's favorite rappers. So,
I break the bar with this gangsta folk story tale. Stacking loot up in the coop that I protect with a Mac 12. Put a slap my clip in the chamber. Fool, your life's in danger. No one will remain when I come through dubbing insane. Call me Bolo Major Pain. The flame.
Water, gentlemen. But, yeah. You know, one song didn't come out. We did two that came out. You feel me?
Yeah, absolutely. So, research say you were one of the first artists signed to Tupac's label.
I never was signed to Tupac's label.
You was never signed to Tupac's label. That was about to come out. That was cut short. It was untimely
yeah, I was going to, you know, we was thinking about it and talking about it, but never got to that point.
Okay.
You feel me? I didn't get to that point, man. I went to the joint and he got killed.
Tragic. So, do you think you were targeted because you were an underground hip hop legend?
Targeted by the police?
Yeah.
I mean, once they got you, they got an army. They got parole and all these things that you got to report. So they always got an eye on you, and then they know you from people in prison. Oh, that nigga rap or whatever the hell, but he doing this and that. So you know they keep a more tighter eye on you than a regular motherfucker. You don't.
Yeah. Absolutely. So you broke over 30 records, and that's not including mixtapes and singles and features. It's probably more than that, guys. You know, I'm not paying enough credence because I really still have more studying to do. Because how do you cover a 30-year career in one short interview? And there's been so many interviews that I've seen. The questions are going to be redundant because he's getting introduced to another decade, 3 decades of hip hop, 4 decades because, you know, a lot of the young kids are having kids young. But you've been in this game, you've watched so many decades pass, so many different avenues of hip hop being created.
Right.
Like, what would you tell the rookie coming up?
Man, really? I always say, you know, just keep going. Keep trying no matter what. If you believe in it, don't let them tell you you can't do it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, anybody, it's, you never know. They got YouTube now. Okay. You know what I'm saying? You never fucking
Twitch.
Know. They got all these different sites for you to promote your shit and for somebody to see you and want to take you big farther than what you're at. You know what I mean? So just keep going. Keep going. Believe in it. Keep working on it.
He's a very busy man, guys. It took a lot of work to get this interview. 30 years in the game. Still highly sought after. We checked your Instagram. You got cult followers. I went to one of his shows on the West Side at the Hit Factory. Shout out to Yogue Westwood. And the guys was like, I'm surrounded by all these guys. I'm always surrounded by guys. But... They knew every word to every song. And you didn't get to perform a lot because niggas start shooting, getting crazy.
Mm-hmm.
You remember the show I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
You know, niggas was mad. They wanted to find the nigga that ruined the show. They ready to murk that nigga. Like, but the love, you can tell that these niggas grew up to your music. They feel your music. They real hardcore fans.
Yeah.
It's the lifestyle.
Lifestyle, man.
So with the lifestyle, how do you handle when they're all, you get online and everybody's hitting you up, everybody want to congratulate you?
I can't talk to everybody.
Right.
We want to see you at the grocery store. I ain't want to pull up on you, you know, all crazy shit like that, but I just want you to know it's all good. All you gotta do is tap in.
Just tell a nigga get up in it, baby, and throw it back like we in the 80s. Don't give a fuck if a nigga hated. The homie got the check, we're solving big equation. So let's ride, baby, let's ride, let's ride. So let's ride, baby, let's ride, let's ride.
Hey, baby, jump in this foreign and let me boss you. In and out of lanes, hop out on them and floss you. Run you in the Neiman Marcus or either sack fist. Probably some matching designer kicks and some baggage. Now that I'm back active, they asking about my action. Multiplication, no subtraction, that's a distraction. West side life that I live is a thug passion. Hennessy out the bottle with the baddest model matching. All the step back in it to the homies, now what's cracking? That was on the south side of Iraq. Say that ain't the realest, they must have been in their feelings. I came out the jungle, made it through a balls for a feeling. Now baby, take my hand, don't mean to toot my horn. They say I'm the next best thing since Soup was born. They call me the fool, so baby, come and get the horn. The tanks, they fool, nah, I ain't one of the norms.
Just tell a nigga get up in it, baby, and throw it back like we in the 80s. Don't give a fuck if a nigga hated. The homie got the track, we're solving big equation. So let's ride.
With exotic keys and bust down rollies, they got a lot of these. Say last boyfriend, he had a lot of G's. Till he took his life for coming short on a lot of keys.
Damn.
Cold path, how the game go?
Should
I retired way back with the Kango.
Kango.
Till I'm jumping out the Benz to the Range Rover. Maserati culling into that Wraith ho.
Wraith ho.
Still married to the mob for that cake dough.
Cake
say I'm focused, mean I'm sinning and I'm faithful.
Mean I'm faithful.
Never switch a snitch, baby, that's hateful.
Never.
I stay blessed over stress, so I'm grateful.
Just tell a nigga get up in it, baby, and throw it back like we in the 80s. Don't give a fuck if a nigga hated. The homie got the track, we're solving big equation. So let's ride, ride, baby, let's ride, let's ride.
We'll be right back.
is coming, so something will be all right.
Make sure you guys follow him on Instagram, Sebo the Mob Father.
Sebo Mob Father.
Sebo Mob Father.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to have it at the bottom of the screen there. Make sure you tap in.
And follow me on TikTok.
Follow him on TikTok. Follow him every social media platform that he have, guys.
Sebo Mob Father all the way across.
Sebo Mob Father across the board. Keep it consistent. That's how OGs do. Real, keep it consistent, right?
Yes.
Keep the pimping consistent.
Yay.
Yay, yay. So we know you're working on movies. You're looking for artists.
Dope-ass artists.
Dope-ass artists.
Not nobody
serious artists. Not because you made a hit song real quick. Like you think it's a hit.
Shot somebody. I don't give a damn. Your shit,
you got a record.
Nice.
You need to be getting your life together. Because this music takes a lot of work. It takes the business side is way more than the show side.
As soon as you take a break, it's over for you.
All gas.
One break.
No breaks.
Yeah, take it for all the gas. It's going to be over.
So, we have 2022 OZ Mob related. Ounce Mob related. What is it?
OZ.
OZ.
What's that?
I don't know. That's what it said. Game Official and West Coast Mafia 2022 OZ Mob related.
That's probably a comp. You know, you do a record with somebody. Somebody else shit.
Okay. But the best of volume one dropped in 2021.
Right.
So can 2023 redrop. Expect a new Sebo album?
Yeah, we just dropped some. We just dropped some about a week ago on a Spotify called Trapped.
Trapped.
Yes.
Look Blow it up your Spotify.
Trapped. Spotify. Trapped. And we need some more listeners on there.
Yeah, we need some more listeners. Go stream the OGs. You don't know where hip-hop is going until you clearly know where it came from. Like, all aspects of hip-hop. I like to say I grew up with hip-hop. So, and as being a lover and, you know, a further of the culture, I want to thank Sebo. I want to thank the West Coast Mafia. I want to thank the facilitators of this amazing setup we got going here at the 420.
Yeah, for sure.
So while I got him on the live, like we've done, he's blessed a lot of my projects, guys. Gave tracks, produced different things like that, featured for me. Thank you so much. I greatly appreciate it. It's all love. It's nice. All love.
Yeah, shout out to the lady boss, man. With the boss in here, man.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Hey. Had to bless my season. This is my first show back. For all those that really ride with me and know about my hiatus, know that what I'm going through. Bless up, boss gang.
I hope y'all heard everything. I know I speak low, you know what I'm saying?
When we got you right here.
Fly, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Shit.
Oh, sorry.
Everybody have a blessed day.
Blessed night. Thanks for tuning in.
Happy 420, baby.
420, 30th anniversary of Gas Chambers.
Yeah.
It's been another session of ITLTTV in this lifetime television. We thank you for tuning in, boss ladies, boss babies. It's all love.
Peace.
The realest, why they be the best? I got a history, criminal tendency. Check out my background, the shit is a mess. I got an itchy trigger finger, I ain't the one you should test. I'm hard to impress, still got a clientele. 400 bills in the truck land, that's a check. I get money.
Man, gotta go out there and support the homegirl, CerSire. You know what I'm saying? ITLTTV, main podcast. You know what I mean? Tap in. Lady Ball, CerSire, you already know what it is. Let's get it, ma.
Any nigga get up in it, baby, and throw it back like we in the 80s. Don't give a fuck if a nigga hated. The homie got the Draco solving big equation. So let's ride.